What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another video. Today we're going to go over five things that I've learned since starting my photography business to help you guys out if you're just starting out now. All right, for those of you who do not know me, my name is Donovan Wagner, and I'm a photographer in British Columbia, Canada. And 9 months ago, I ventured out and started my own photography business. Now, I've been doing photography for many years before that, but it was 9 months ago that I took the plunge, registered a business that has been my sole income and my only career now. So I'm gonna go over some things that I've learned over these last 9 months that can really help you guys if you're just starting out now or you're in the same boat as me. So starting with number one is that I used to let gear be more of a roadblock or an excuse than it needed to be. So what I mean by that is it's kind of the what came first, the chicken or the egg scenario. Now, should you need to invest in a whole bunch of different lenses and cameras and lighting, or should you really start mastering the skills with the equipment you already have and then evolving over time, purchasing more gear once you need it or you become more profitable? Now, I definitely took a plunge when I first started the business and bought more stuff than I probably even needed. But what I've definitely learned over time is that it's more beneficial to learn the skills, and then when you do get the gear later on, it's going to better use, basically. The second thing that I've learned is when selling your services, it becomes a lot harder when you're selling for yourself as opposed to for someone else. So it's always hard. It's kind of a fine line you're walking. But what I've found really helps is that if you provide a solution for your client's problems, then it becomes an investment and not a cost. So the second lesson I've learned here is definitely sales related. And don't get me wrong, I was terrible at it and I'm probably still not the best at selling for myself. But when you can sit down and have a conversation and almost explain what your services are solving for the client, they will manifest in their head as to why they should invest in that. So it's always better to sell your services as a solution to someone's problem, and that will actually also help create a longer standing relationship rather than a one-time shoot. Now, the third lesson I've definitely learned over the last 9 months is basically managing my time, where I should be allocating my time when tons of people, especially on social media, are reaching out for collaborations, which don't get me wrong, collaboration's important, but also knowing when and where and how to collaborate is also important. Because if you're basically spending all of your spare time doing all these free shoots for someone else that's not really helping guide your business where you want it to go, then it's a waste of time at the end of the day, because A, you're not getting paid, and B, it's not strengthening your skills where you should be strengthening your skills. So that's another thing I've definitely learned over the last little while, is that collaborations are very important, but also very time consuming. So be aware of what collaborations make sense for you, and then don't be afraid to turn down the ones that don't, because that time can be better spent doing marketing or sales for yourself. And the fourth thing I've learned kind of relates to number three, sort of with time management, and that is also taking breaks and taking time for yourself and your family. It's easy as a solopreneur when you're just starting out to go all in and think that you know you have to work 10 times harder than any employee. And to a certain degree, absolutely you need to. But at the same time, it's also important to have that self-care aspect so that you don't burn out and go into resentment towards your career path. So definitely taking a little bit of time, having, you know, designated work hours and designated workspace, where you can really buckle down when you need to, but also have that ability to turn that off and go be with your family and be a regular human being. So definitely managing your time as a solopreneur is very important, I've learned. And the fifth lesson I've learned since starting my own business, and I'm still kind of going through this one constantly, is whether you should niche down into something very specific or remain having a wide variety of services. So I'm kind of trying to niche down at the moment into the things that I'm most passionate about, because I also believe that what you're most passionate about is basically what your best work is going to be. And then once you become an authority in that division, the clients and the money will come later on. So I'm kind of going through this process right now where I'm rebranding a little bit, and rather than saying yes to every kind of job, is just more focusing on what I'm best at or what I'm most passionate about, and then narrowing it down from there. So, I mean, by all means, if you guys have any advice regarding niching down in your area or your expertise, please let me know in the comments below what your guys' theory is behind it, if you should be niching down or if you think that that will restrict and limit you. It has been definitely an interesting 9 months. I've learned a ton of things since I've started my own business, and you know, hopefully this video can help you guys out there if you're just starting out or you're thinking about starting out. It's all part of the fun, and I would not change anything for the world. I wouldn't regret anything I've done so far. So thank you guys so much for watching. If you like what you see, please hit that subscribe button. I plan on doing a lot more videos this year as well. So thank you so much, and I'll see you guys in the next video.